Tune in to Overcomers TV on your favorite app or streaming platform. It's time to overcome.
Well, thanks for continuing to watch this episode of Answering the Call. We're so excited to be in Louisville, Texas, right outside of Dallas-Fort Worth, visiting International Commission. With me, the president, Brent Edwards, talking about evangelism and Project Andrew. So, evangelism, what's your take?
Well, Chuck, many, many years ago, as I've mentioned before, our founder, Ben Meath, came across the process early on called Operation Andrew. For those in America who are familiar, of course, with Dr. Billy Graham's crusades all through the years, what they may not know is, and they will tell you this, one of the reasons those were so resoundingly successful is because of the preparation through prayer and people going and working through churches for a whole year before that process, before that, in many times, crusade in a stadium. Well, by their permission, for all of these years, we have used that model. It's a prayer preparation model where there's seven steps. Yeah. And I'll tell you honestly, Chuck, that's the game changer. Now, don't get me wrong. I don't believe that ministries are going without prayer. But because we have seen so many times people's eyes open immediately, literally and spiritually, because they have been prayed over. And this model, they write down 10 names of 10 people on a little card. I have one right here. A little card, and write down those names, and they pray for them for 6 months to a year. And then our team, in the case of an international project, comes in, and they are taken to their homes. We don't do evangelism in a stadium or things like that.
Soapbox preaching, no soapbox preaching.
None of that. No,
it's relationship.
It's a relationship built thing, and then they continue the relationship. Our model is what we call 45-10-45. 45 is prayer and preparation before there's discipling going on there. 10% of the time is while the intentional evangelism is going on with the U.S. team in the case of international projects, and I'll explain that in a moment, and their folks who have been praying and preparing. And then the other 45 is the discipleship that happens afterward. And they're, again, in that process for a whole year before.
And I think we as a church underestimate the power of prayer. Some have said nothing really happens in the real world without a half an hour, or a half an hour in the real world without a half an hour of somebody on their knees.
Right, exactly.
So why do we underestimate the power of prayer? Jesus taught us how to pray and pray without ceasing. You know, there's just a lot of verses that tell us, talk to God about it.
You know what's convicting about that, Chuck, for me, is I was a worship pastor. And I recognize, of course, the need and the power of prayer and preparing for that time of worship every week. But I'll tell you honestly, just like sometimes I caught myself on Sunday morning running in, and I was the stage manager, the leader, the singer, the whole thing, and going, oh yeah, how long did we stop to pray? Well, that's the beauty of this. We know they're praying for months in advance before the team even gets there. It's powerful.
And like you talk about prayer and preparation, that's really what's happening. God's preparing your heart, so when you see the opportunity you've been talking to him about, you don't miss it, right?
Correct.
That's good. So evangelism, again, there's a lot of misconceptions about that word, and some people in the church think you even need to be an evangelist because of Billy Graham and people that were specialists because they practiced for a while. But we're all supposed to be doing evangelism. True?
Beauty of this, really, I say it many times, one of the reasons, other than the obvious, which is the Holy Spirit is all surrounding it all the time, is it's so simple. We tell people, if you are saved, you can recite John 3:16, and you have a testimony, then you're prepared to go. Now, that's a little oversimplified because we do more than that. But that's the point. Everyone is called to it, and everyone, once they've come to know Jesus Christ, does have a testimony of faith and can therefore, in most cases, share their story and simply say, now, basically to the person, do you have a story like that? And that's where that relationship is built with the team member, but it's already been built with the person in the village, in the town. And the beauty of it too, Chuck, you didn't ask this, but the way that the growth happened for IC was in the 90s, instead of just doing projects that originated with U.S. churches going around the world, because of a couple of situations, they said, don't cancel the project that you were planning to do, just let us do it. That birthed what we call national to national projects. And as you said a moment ago, It's not Americans go tell them, show them, be the ministry. Right. It's equip and enable them to be the evangelists in their community. Yeah. And that's when things just blossom beyond imagination.
Right. Yeah, I love Ephesians 4:11. God gave some of the apostles, prophets, evangelists, pastors, teachers to equip the body for the work of ministry. It's the body parts that do the work.
Exactly. As I said to you last night over dinner, in 2018, 2019, God allowed us to see over 3.4 million decisions for Christ. That's verifiable decisions, but that's not proud, nor is that the work of a few American evangelists going. Right. It's because of all those people throughout the nations, over 1.4 million volunteers, if you want to call them that, members of churches, under the leadership of approximately 400 national leaders around the world. Right. They were the army. Going out, and that's how God has used this ministry.
Well, what I love about your ministry is that it's intentional. So there's, I would say, in the life of a Christian, when he starts looking for opportunities to share the gospel and recognizing it and doing it, that's a big day versus keeping it in your pocket, keeping it a secret.
Well, we say it all the time. All of us say it. It's not the great suggestion. It's the great commission.
Right.
And yes, we are to go, but part of what we're to do is to help them understand the possibility of an eternal relationship with Jesus, but then also put them in touch with believers in their world that can help disciple them into a growth which then becomes the multiplication, which enables a numbers like what I just said to happen.
Well, stay tuned. We're going to get some more interviews from some of the folks here at International Commission talking about Operation Andrew and how you too can get involved with this great ministry, reaching the world with the gospel of Jesus.
Celebrate what Jesus is doing throughout the nation and rise up to answer his call on your life. To serve the poor, heal the broken, free the captives, and bring joy to those in need. Find hope, encouragement, and motivation through Overcomers TV. This inspiring network features everyday people and ministries across America who are putting God's love in action. Tune in to Overcomers TV on your favorite app or streaming platform. It's time to overcome.